He said there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't nothing in this world for free. I know I can't slow down, I can't hold back. Though you know I wish I could. Oh no, there ain't no rest for the wicked until we close our eyes for good.
Hey everybody, back again, and today we're going to be making a PVC bow out of a piece of schedule 40 3/4 inch pipe. This is going to be 5 foot long before I start. This is my first attempt at making one of these, and I am going to completely hand form this, so you shouldn't need too many special tools. I'll show you guys what we're going to be using here in just a sec, but before we get started, I just wanted to shout out the Backyard Bowyer and thank him for all of the videos that he did, because he showed very well how to make all kinds of different shapes of bow out of PVC. He's gotten some pretty crazy draw weights. He's made 80 pound long bows, he's made 40 pound small recurves, he's made some pretty insane stuff. So if you're looking to see how this is done, check out his video. This is more so going to be how my attempt goes at making this. This is my first attempt. If this goes well, I have some fiberglass rods and another piece of this that's the same size that I'm going to attempt to make a higher draw weight version. So we're going to start with this one today, see how it goes. And if it goes well, we're going to make another one in another video with some fiberglass reinforcement. For this project, you will need some PVC pipe, schedule 40 or schedule 80. 3/4 inch or 1 inch, depending on the pressure you want. And then a heat gun or a source of heat, because PVC, when it gets heated up, becomes moldable, and you'll see that here in the video. Another thing that I've seen that's very helpful is having a piece of angle iron with some aluminum foil on it to kind of create an area where you can focus your heat on your PVC pipe to get a more even heat. I'm gonna be doing hand molding on this, so I'm gonna shape most of this completely by hand. You're gonna need a chainsaw file in order to put in the knocks, or you can just use a jigsaw. So without further ado, let's hook the heat gun up, get started. So you'll see the markings that I've put on here. I've got 4 inches and 6 inches from the end. This is gonna be a recurve portion for our bow, or reflex, depending on how you define it. But basically this is to tell me where I want my bends. And then I've got 2 inches from either side marked out for my handle. I might actually make that into a 6 inch section, add an inch on either side for the actual shaping for the shelf, if I create a shelf. And then on the other side, obviously the same thing. One thing to note when you're doing this is PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride. PVC releases chlorine gas when it is being heated, so make sure you're doing this in a well-ventilated area. So I'm just gonna heat up this section here in between my recurve markings and start to heat up this one limb. And from what I've seen, you just wanna be careful to avoid overheating it. As long as you're not yellowing your PVC pipe, you can see it's becoming very flexible now, but as long as you don't yellow it or blister it, you should be good. And that's just a safety thing. You don't want to overcook it. Got my one limb flattened through here. And I'm going to just create that taper the rest of the way up on this. Okay, so we've got our one limb flattened. And as you can see, it's a nice steady thickness through here. And then right before that marking, about an inch before that marking, it starts to slope off and gets thinner. Now we're just gonna repeat the same thing on the other side. Okay, while it's nice and flexible, we're just gonna go ahead and start pressing it down. And one thing that the guy from the Backyard Bowyer made very clear, I think his name is Nick, is that as it cools, when it starts to get harder, that's the areas you're gonna wanna press on a little stiffer, a little harder, to get it to set in that position. And you will definitely want gloves, because this stuff is very, very hot. Check and make sure everything's in line. Make sure everything stays straight. So we made that taper a little too stiff, so I'm just gonna heat this section up, make that a little more gradual. Okay, now that we've got our limbs started, I'm gonna go ahead and heat the handle up and I'm gonna squish it this way a little bit to make it a little stiffer in this direction. So now I'm just gonna carefully start squeezing it sideways. Also gonna add just a little bit of deflex here at the handle. Just get it to lean forward just a hair from either side. This is just gonna add a little bit more potential energy storage to the bow. And you can kind of see it forms almost a double taper here at the handle. So it gets nice and thick right through here, which is gonna help prevent it from bending where we don't want it to bend, because we want all that bend to be in our limbs, like that. We don't want that handle to bend at all. Now we're just gonna take our paint can here, and we're actually gonna use the side of it to form those recurve sections on the ends. So I'm gonna go ahead and heat it up through here, and I'm gonna bend those forward. I'm just gonna hold it here in this shape until it starts to cool down and hold that shape. Just gonna keep it on there until it conforms to that curvature. And now I'm gonna go ahead and do that same thing on the other side. Same thing as before, I'm just gonna put it on here and roll that paint can away from myself until I get that angle that I'm looking for. And the trick here is, from what I've seen, not to collapse your pipe. If it does collapse, you can fix it. Just have to heat it back up and squeeze the sides. That's not that big of a deal. But we got our two recurve portions put in. I'm gonna heat this up again, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of deflex to it, okay? You just add that little bit of bend right in the center. Okay, so we've got our bow all heat shaped. Gave it a pretty good recurve on either end. This is a 5 foot long bow. And then all I did on the ends here was just cut some quick and dirty notches. I'll clean those up with the file later, just so that way I can fit a bowstring to it. Right now we're just gonna use some 550 paracord. We've just tied a loop on either end and measured it 4 inches shorter than one of the limbs. If you've never seen how to string a bow, you slide one loop all the way over the end, then you hook it on your notch on the other side. You step through, and then you can bend it back and hook it in place. So, looks like we've got a pretty decent bend. Looks like our limbs are actually bending pretty evenly. Looks like this is going to be our top limb. If one of your limbs bends more than the other, that one will become your top limb. So since that top, this one up here bends more, that's going to be our top limb. Feels like it's about 25 to 35 pounds, somewhere in there. Let's take a couple shots with it and see how it does. Right here, I'm about 10 yards from my target. Try and get a feel for where it's gonna put the arrows. That was better. I'll call that a success. I'm gonna go ahead and paint this, and then I'll show you guys what I'm gonna use for an arrow rest to stop it from scratching up the surface of the bow. So right now I've just got a couple of different colors of paint on here. I've got an espresso, a lighter brown, and a dark walnut. Then I'm gonna do a weaver wrap on the handle to create a small arrow rest. And then I'll show you guys what I'm gonna put on the side there to prevent it from having any issues in the future. So I actually decided to make the
ends of the limbs nice and bright, and I'm gonna hit it with another layer of this bright stuff just over, lightly, over the course of the whole thing, like I've done on the back here, once it dries, just to give it as much of a natural wood look as possible.
So here we are after painting. Draw weight is about 25 to 30 pounds on this. I have a 30 pound regular recurve bow, and this feels almost identical to it in terms of the pull weight and the release. It is a pretty snappy little thing, and I'm gonna shoot it at 20 yards here, my normal shooting distance for my 30, just to see how it does with these heavier 500 spine arrows. Just to show you guys what it looks like when it's unstrung versus strung, this is what we're working with when it's not strung. It's got a little bit of deflex in the limbs, and then these nice about 8-inch recurve sections on either end. If you've seen my archery videos recently, you would have seen this piece of particle board kind of target we got going on here. I'm gonna step back to 20 yards and I'm gonna shoot at this and see if it'll penetrate, just to get an idea of the output of power. I wanna see what it hits like. So, it looks like it's got a pretty good amount of power as long as I get it to full draw. It's punching all the way through and hitting the foam. So it's, I would say, roughly equivalent to that 30 pound bow that I was shooting before. I'm actually fairly impressed for PVC how well this is working. These two that stuck into the wood behind that particle board are working pretty good. I mean, they stuck in just about the same depth as the arrows out of the store-bought 30 pound recurve. Our bow is all finished up, shoots great, it's a fun time. It's a nice little long recurve bow. I did a nice little paracord wrap, and then I used some Velcro, the soft felt from the Velcro, to keep it from having the arrows chip and scrape up the paint job on this. And then I created an arrow rest just out of some paracord with that wrap. So when I'm going to shoot, my arrow can sit right on top of that little rest there while I draw it back. All in all, I have to say I'm pretty pleased with how this turned out. The flex on both limbs is pretty even. Not bad at all. This is the first time I've ever made a PVC bow, and I was actually thinking these things were junk for a long time. I never made one because I didn't think they were any good. But after shooting this, I'm pleasantly surprised. But that does it for today's video. If you guys like what you've seen, you know what to do. Do the thing right there. And until next time, God bless. Stay sharp out there. If you're looking for a custom sharp object, check out the Etsy store.